only one can be the creamiest, because only one is made with Velveeta cheese sauce. Definitely not a powder. The creamiest. There's only one. Velveeta,
Velveeta. She's sleeping with the enemy.
What's going on here? Answer me!
And now, she's caught.
I'm gonna kill you.
The trail leads to revenge. Quick. Turn on the light.
Destroy your campaign.
Guiding light.
They'll regret what they've done for the rest of their lives.
If Bolel's working out, doing 60 minutes. When the show's over, Bo knows it's time to do push-ups with his other arm.
Lead to murder.
Him.
Will Nick be seduced into a cold-blooded trap? Forever Night, tonight on CBS Late Night. This is CBS.
It's a special place. It's where you live. And when you want to make it better, we're ready to help. At Rent-A-Center, you don't need a lot of cash or any deposit. We give you credit for who you are. And we have just what you're looking for. Rent-to-own the Sanyo Home Theater System, just $17.99 a week. And we now rent personal computers. Every rental includes free delivery and free service. Remember, when you're ready to make your life better, nobody brings it home like Rent-A-Center.
I love my baby so, give her the best I know.
Introducing Kleenex Huggies Baby Wipes. Clean like a washcloth.
Huggies Baby Wipes clean quickly, clean like no other type thing.
Huggies Baby Wipes. Textured to clean like a washcloth, to gently grip and clean away the moss.
Huggies Baby Wipes clean, gently clean like no others I've seen.
On the next Donahue, Campaign 92, built in Nashville, Tennessee, with presidential frontrunners Bill Clinton and Al Gore.
Tuesday at 5 on WJBK TV2.
The music world is mourning the death of Eddie Kendrick. We'll look back on the career of this Motown legend on TV2 First News today at 4.
Well, I knew Bob had taken some days off, but I thought it was to be here to help you out.
No, he flew to Montego so that he could work in Sabrina's clinic down there. I mean, he offered to stay here, but there's really nothing that he could do, so.
Brad?
Yeah, in the den, Mom.
Yeah,
I was just telling Larry. He called here, too.
Oh.
Well, listen, I should get out of your way. I'll go over and see if Emily's home. And...
Oh, I didn't see your car on the driveway. You and Susan having dinner with her tonight?
I am. Susan's in Montego.
Excuse me, staring, but I'm just over the shock of seeing you walk in here.
No, I'm in the same boat. I flew down with Inez because she was all homesick and depressed and decided she wanted to have a baby in her own country.
That's understandable. Where is she?
She's saying hello to her friends. She's off the road. Larry and I thought we were doing the best thing for her, but we never considered her feelings.
Well, did Larry fly down with you?
No, he didn't.
Are you all right? I know you were hoping... We were all hoping that Matt and Cal would find some trace of Holden in
Bible. You know, the thing that I really don't understand that really confuses me is that Holden would sell his car to the crewman. That really doesn't make any sense. Oh, how the hell are we going to take all this?
Well, surely Lucinda wouldn't tell her while she's still in Zurich.
Well, I hope not. Now, maybe I should call Lucinda and tell her that I...
Oh, dear. Are you all right, Emma? Are you...
No, no, I'm just a little dizzy.
Why don't you let me call Lucinda?
Okay, thank you. I think maybe I'll go outside to some air.
Please protect me.
Folgers. I tried the Folgers switch on three of my fellow sisters. Instead of our usual ground coffee, I made Folgers crystals. They all complimented me on the taste and aroma. You do make wonderful coffee, was repeated more than once. They never realized it was Folgers crystals.
Folgers crystals, proven to surprise fresh brewed coffee drinkers.
Tastefully yours, Sister Mary Norbert Bauer.
In tests, people who took Unisoft fell asleep 23 minutes faster than those who didn't. You can't buy a more effective sleep aid without a prescription. Take Unisoft and fall asleep faster.
Nighttime, one of the worst times for pain. Minor arthritis pain, muscle aches, pain that seems to go on. That's why you need Ultra Strength Bengay, the strongest Bengay ever. You can say goodnight to your pain with Ultra Strength Bengay.
When I was little, I was always getting caught with my hand in the cookie jar. And I still love sweet things. Like Sunsweet pitted prunes. So you see, nothing changed. Except my cookie jar.
When babies teeth, their little mouths go through big pain. Stop it with Baby Ambisol, because it gives temporary relief on contact. Alcohol-free Baby Ambisol.
There you go.
Oh, thanks. I need this.
Well, it's too bad Larry couldn't get the time off to come down with you.
Well, this thing, you know, with Inez happened so fast. And first, Bianca was supposed to fly down here, and then Lucinda quashed that. So I couldn't let Inez fly down here alone.
How much time off do you have?
Actually, I'm taking a leave of absence.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Well, does that mean you can stay and do some work around here?
Yes, I'm going to stay until Inez has her baby next month.
Oh. Well, I don't have to tell you how much your help is needed here. Several of the people that I treated asked about you and Larry.
Oh, yeah? There are a lot of wonderful memories here.
Well, it's an incredible feeling. You leave here at night, I mean, no matter how exhausted you are, the kind of gratification we don't get at home. You and Inez have any plans for dinner?
No.
Well, I'm due at Sabrina's. Why don't I call her and tell her that you two will be with her?
Do you think that's a good idea? I mean, Sabrina knows our history.
Susan, let's put that to rest. What happened with us was important to both of us for a lot of reasons. But you said it. It's history. Sabrina knows that things are good with Kim and me. And that you and Larry are going to be married.
Hi, everybody. I'm sorry I'm late. I got held up at the office going over proposals.
Listen, don't worry about a thing. They've been taking great care of me.
Well, I did manage to shop on the way. So, listen, do you guys want to join us for dinner? I'm sure there'll be enough.
Thanks, honey. I want to spend some time with Chris.
Yeah, and I'm really just looking forward to hanging out with my sister.
Okay, but please come have dinner with me sometime. I never see you guys since I moved to backyard.
Well, I actually wouldn't bother coming
here. I didn't realize he was gone, was he?
Franny just told me he was in Montego.
Oh.
Well, we gotta go. Time for dinner.
Well, it's, you and Franny change your mind, just stop by.
Thank you. Thanks. Bye, guys.
Well, I suppose it was kind of a shock for you to find out that Susan was in Montego. Must have been kind of a sudden decision.
Yeah, it was, Mom. She flew down there with Inez and, I didn't really want to say anything when Mary was still here. But she broke off their engagement. Gave him back the ring and left a note saying that she just couldn't go through with it.
No, really?
Yes.
How's Larry taking that?
Pretty hard. I just feel really sorry for him, Mom. He's been so good to me through this whole thing with Daryl and now this.
Yeah, he really has been.
Well, I'm really sorry. That's too bad.
And
well, I just wanted to drop my stuff off. I want to go pick Chris up from his play date, but I'm going to stop and say hello to him and Margo.
Anything I can do for you?
No, no, not really. Anything special you want for dinner?
How about the Green Goblin?
Oh, okay.
My favorite.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll see you later. Hey, Mom.
Yeah.
You do know Susan being in Montego has nothing to do with Daddy, right? I mean, that was over for good a long time ago.
I know. Good to hear you say it.
See you later, honey.
Bye. Hello. Yeah, is this you?
Yeah. Can you talk?
Yeah, I'm here by myself.
Can you meet me at the same motel later tonight?
Sure. Does this mean that...
Look, I can't talk. I'll explain later. Room 18, I'll be there as close to 8 as I can make it.
I couldn't reach the agenda. Secretary wouldn't put my call through, so I left a message
for you to call you. Okay, thank you. Thank you for calling, sweetheart. What's your saying? Stay have some dinner with us, okay?
Well, I'd love to have dinner here at the farm, but, you know, Caleb will probably...
Now, look, Angel, I don't want you to feel uncomfortable in my home. Not ever. Now, I made that very clear to Caleb.
I love you, sweetheart. I do. But I really think it's best for me. Angel, hi.
Hi.
Good to see you.
Hi,
Angel.
Mrs. Snyder, did Hutch call at all?
No, not yet. And Danny, why don't we go make some dinner?
Okay. I gotta wash up. Emma called. Told me the news about Holden, and she sounded so upset. That's why I came over.
You don't have to make excuses for being here. I'm sure it meant a lot to Mama.
Well, I'm gonna head back over to Lily's in case she calls from Zurich.
If she does, maybe it's a good idea if you don't...
I know. Caleb, I'm awful worried about your mama. I don't know how best to help her. Maybe if you could just get her to talk about it a little bit.
I will. You sure you have to run off?
Just hope they eat everything.
Be careful.
Mama,
why don't we have the whole clan out tonight, huh? Kirk and Ellie, John and I.
Well, Ivan and John are probably on their way to Foxwood
Lodge.
Yes, they're probably married by now.
That's right, I forgot all about that. With everything going on. Oh, you know that Rosanna has more than made up for Hutch not being here. As a matter of fact, she's done work of two men. I think we ought to maybe pay her double. What do you think?
Hello?
Emma, my secretary just gave me the message that Angel called me.
Well, actually, I wanted to speak to you, Lucinda. I was thinking, I don't think we should tell Lily while she's in Zurich about what happened.
Oh,
hey. Oh, my goodness. Lily's here.
Yes, she is. She came back sooner than anyone expected. She fainted here in my office, I'm afraid, when she heard the news about Holden. I'm very worried, Emma. I did my best to stop her from going out there to the farm because I think the worst thing possible for her would be to be bombarded with memories of Holden.
I'm so sorry, Lily. I'm so sorry.
I feel better just being here.
Reminder, Lubriderm Motion restores lost moisture to heal your dry skin and protect it. Remember, the one created for dermatologists is the one that heals and protects. Lubriderm. See you later, alligator.
Those greasy chips have more fat than these Mountaineers.
Who are you?
Mr. Phipps, introducing Tater Crisps. They're baked, not fried like ordinary chips.
Crunchy potato taste.
What's that?
Tater Crisps from Mr. Phipps.
What if you could get the fiber you need for regularity in a crisp, delicious wafer?
Well, now you can. Metamucil wafers. All the effectiveness of Metamucil, and it tastes like a cookie. Metamucil wafers.
Life is just a bowl of sherry. Don't take it serious. Life's too mysterious. You work, you save.
Today, women need all the comfort and support they can get. Is it any wonder so many women see Playtex as the frog they love to live in?
Life is just a bowl of cherry. So live and laugh at it all.
Is there a double standard at Franny's house?
I think women should wait until they're married.
The only women who wait for sex these days are called wives.
Franny's turn, Saturday. CBS has a heat. An all-new season of quality drama.
He's a witness.
Carol O'Connor, Howard Rollins, in the heat of the night, Wednesdays after baseball.
Can I pour you a drink?
No, thanks. I'll have a little wine with dinner. Why don't you put that in an IV and go right for the big vein?
Very funny. You know, the truth is, I quit drinking this stuff when I moved in with your mom.
I knew she had a problem with it.
Now I've started drinking it again because she walked out. I guess that makes her my problem. That makes sense?
Almost. Listen, I know that you're really hurting over this. But whatever happened, Mom loves you. It's just all this insecurity with Franny. Would you get that? Maybe Kim and Franny changed their mind about dinner.
Oh, hi, Larry.
Hi.
I'm sorry, I didn't know you were busy. I brought a bottle of wine over to celebrate today's meeting.
Well, that was very sweet of you, Evan, but we'll have to do it another time. I invited Larry over for dinner, and he's got a lot to talk about.
Sure. I should have called ahead first. Well, anyway, maybe we can celebrate tomorrow night after we get a signature on a contract.
Maybe. You're going to be rushing things a little.
We'll see. Look, how about coming into work early tomorrow? I got another brainstorm.
I'll be there. Thanks for the wine.
Good night.
Good night.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to be messing up your dance card.
Oh, don't worry about it. Where were we?
And if I know.
Oh, I know what I was saying. Listen, I think Mom just needs a little time. And then she'll realize you're the best thing that ever happened to her and come flying home.
Nice try, kiddo. She's not going to come flying home, at least until Inez has her baby. I don't know, Emily. Maybe the reason she hasn't set a date for the wedding, maybe because she doesn't feel the same way about me that I do about her.
Mom, listen, people aren't rushing in getting married like they used to. Look at John and Iva. Mom just told me Iva's pregnant. They're just getting married now.
Is that supposed to make me feel better?
Confirm what he'd heard right outside the store, that Aaron is his son. You know that I love Lily and I would never do anything to hurt her.
Darling, you can fool yourself, but you can't fool me. Whatever John stands for, if you had to choose between John and between sparing Lily more pain...
Now, wait a minute. You have no right to say something like that.
I do have every right to say that. Until she fell under your spell, she was never going to tell.
And then he told you to undoubtedly sacrifice. I would never sacrifice Lily's happiness for John or anyone else.
You were off with John tying the knot.
Lila, can the boys stay with you for a couple hours? Margaret's not there, right? Call me if she comes there, and I'll do the same on this end. Thanks, bye. Well, she's not there. But Lila called and ruined your nuptial plans.
The Foxwood Lodge will be around for a long time, believe me.
You know, I was thinking about that night Margaret went out there.
get a bottle of red wine, and I'm sitting here joking with
Dustin. Oh, no, wait a minute. It's not your fault. Don't do that to yourself. Now, was she depressed this morning?
No, I mean, she didn't appear to be. We did our run as usual, and I was supposed to meet her for lunch, but I had to cancel because of the campaign, but she seemed fine. Hey, what's wrong?
I don't know.
Where you been? I've been worried sick about you.
Well,
that makes two of us.
What are you doing here? You're supposed to be getting married.
You know, I can still remember the very first candy given to me by my grandfather. It was Werther's Original, and I was four. I had a little trouble opening that shiny golden wrapper, but then, well, I'll never forget that first taste. Sweet and creamy and just plain good. But there was something else, too. I remember feeling I must be somebody very special when my grandpa gave me his wonderful butter candy. So, now I'm the grandfather. And what else would I give my little grandson but my Werther's Original? He's somebody special, too.
Ooh, the shine you get. Special effects from Alberto Styling. New Alberto Frizz Solver and Shine Enhancer. One drop or 10 frizzies heightened shine. Ooh, the looks you get with special effects from Alberto.
With all the children's cold medicines out there, how many do you think relieve every major cold symptom? Only one. Introducing new children's Tylenol Cold plus cough. The only one you need.
Now getting rid of a yeast infection is a lot easier. Introducing disposable cardboard applicators. Only from Monistat 7. One more reason why Monistat is more than just a cure.
Nina, the loose cannon.
We can't just sit around and wait to see what Nina will do. The woman is dangerous.
And she's got the ammunition to blow Victoria and Ryan's marriage out of the water.
Ryan and I belong together. We were meant to be together.
It all explodes.
What the hell were you trying to pull anyway?
Weekdays on The Young and the Restless. This is CBS on TV2.
Man, I don't believe you two sitting around here worrying about me. Knock, knock. Hey, Tom.
Hi.
Tom, what are you doing here? I thought you were up at Foxwood Lodge with Margo.
Well, I just wanted to make sure that Margo was okay.
Why, what's wrong? Absolutely nothing.
Absolutely nothing. She left the station hours ago. Was supposed to go to Lila to pick up the boys, and she never showed up.
Yeah, what took you so long?
Well, I was leaving the station, and I got a call from Dorothy Stanley. She's one of Nevin's rape victims, and she was on her way to find out the results of her HIV test, and she was freaking out, so I went with her, and now I'm here.
So, what were the results?
She's negative. I'm going to call Mama. Hello?
Margo? Hi, it's me. Can you talk?
Yeah, sure, sort of. What's up?
Not much new, really. I'm keeping a close eye on our friend George Jessup. Mainly, I just called to see how you were doing.
Such a surprise to see my beautiful Lily here home so soon.
Well, I finished my business in Zurich, and I was anxious to come home because I thought there'd be good news.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine now. I just need to be around people who love Holden. Do you think I'll ever see him again?
Oh, don't say that. Of course you will. Of course you will.
Lillian, Mama's right. When Ned and Cal get back, maybe they'll have some more details about the crewman who bought Holden's
car. What are you talking about?
I thought that Lucinda told you.
What?
Well, Holden wasn't on the freighter, but his car was. And one of the crewmen claims that he bought it from Holden, so that's something.
Why would Holden sell his car? Why would he be desperate for cash?
I don't know. I've asked myself the question over and over again. I really cannot make any sense of it all.
Hi. Boy, that's a pretty picture.
What are you doing out here, Evan?
Well, I had a drink with your father a while ago, but the rest of my night's free.
Well, mine isn't. I have a lot of work to do.
I can see that. And I bet you can talk and feel at the same time. In fact, I'm going to give you a hand. That way you'll be done in half the time, and you can spend the rest of your evening with me.
Hey, you know, I'm pretty handy with salad spinner. Why don't you let me make a salad while you get showered and changed?
You've got yourself a deal, McDermott. I'll be back. And do us both a favor and lay off the scotch. Freddie!
Hi.
You change your mind about dinner?
No, I'm sorry. I'm going out later, but thank you.
Well, I'm about to jump in the shower, and I'll be out in a few minutes, so why don't you hang out for a little bit?
Okay.
Thanks.
Hi.
Hi.
The real reason I came over is because I wanted to thank you for being there for me during this whole crisis with Daryl, and, well, I just want you to know if there's anything I can do for you, anything at all, please, just feel free to ask.
Thanks, friend. Thanks a lot. I don't know what to do. You know, part of me wants to jump on a plane, fly down to Montego. Part of me wants to stay put, give her time, give her space.
Maybe that's the smartest thing to do, Larry.
You know, I remember a year and a half ago, you asked me to do the same thing, and you ended up marrying somebody else.
There's no Daryl waiting in the wings to take Susan away. Oh, come on, Larry. Surely you don't think that Daddy is...
Nah.
No?
Right over.
Okay, I'll...
Okay.
I'm sorry, I have to ask. Your problems with Susan, does it have anything to do with your spending time with me?
Yeah. She feels threatened by you. No matter how much I try to reassure her.
Well, there's some irony for you. I mean, here I am trying to make my way back to Daryl, and he feels jealous and threatened by my relationship with you.
Yeah, but he has no reason to feel that way. I had a salad around.
You sure did. Just do it, buddy. I'll see you later.
How's Carrie doing? Is she over her virus?
Oh, yeah, she's doing great. It's as if she was never sick at all. She's a healthy little girl.
I'll
see you. Hello.
Hello? I don't know, Larry. I don't think anybody's on the other end.
A night for its 7 p.m.
This day won't go away.
My allowance!
Oh, your vacation?
Canceled.
I can't sleep and my head aches.
You want Excedrin PM. Strong aspirin-free headache medicine you can feel good about. Plus a gentle ingredient to help you sleep.
Mother is staying indefinitely.
Make a bad day go away with Excedrin PM. And rest assured it's aspirin-free.
If I even look at a sink full of dishes, my hands go crazy. But now there's new Palmolive Sensitive Skin for dishes. It's free of dyes and the harshest irritants. It's even dermatologist tested. New Palmolive Sensitive Skin. It's dishwashing made less irritating.
Okay, what's totally unique and a whole lot of fun? Cracker Jack, of course. Now there's new Butter Toffee Cracker Jack. We made this delicious buttery toffee and poured it all over crunchy popcorn, plus peanuts and a fun fry. Yep, if it's important, it's gotta be good.
Come with me to a place where there is no time.
Introducing a breakthrough in carpet beauty. The first nylon carpet with permanent stain protection.
Walk into my world where beauty comes from within.
These for life. Stain protection warranted to last for the carpet's lifetime.
Where all that is beautiful comes and on.
These for life carpet. For the nearest showroom, call 1-800-LEASE.
Continue with part two of As the World Turns. In just a moment.
This is only the beginning. Last landing. Thursdays after the World Series.
This is CBS.
Hey, Mom! You know, your child could be a model.
Really? How?
Enter Kid Search 92, the most exciting model contest for kids. Over $1 million in prizes. Any kid or teen can enter. There's no experience necessary.
So, what do I do now?
Go to any JCPenney portrait studio. Fill out an entry.
dealer sold his millionth piece of original recipe, he had a Colonel Lookalike contest. How better to celebrate the world-famous original recipe chicken? It's what all the lookalikes ate, including the winner, whose resemblance was uncanny. And now get the Colonel's Dozen for just $9.99. 12 pieces of chicken, large mashed potatoes with gravy, and a large coleslaw. A meal for your entire family. The Colonel's Dozen, only $9.99. In Lake Edna or your neck of the woods.
Bo loves working out doing 60 minutes. When the show's over, Bo knows it's time to do push-ups with his other arm.
WJBK, TV2, Detroit.
And now, part two of As the World Turns.
Hello?
Karen?
Hi.
I told Dr. Sussman how you reacted to the gangster movie. How you reacted when the car rushed to the camera.
It all seems so real to me.
In that old movie, when the car came hurtling toward you, did you remember anything at all? The accident? Anything?
The only thing that I remember is that you told me the car hit me. The rest is blank.
I understand your frustration. Aaron, the truth is pushing yourself to remember won't work because you can't remember. If you have the strength to accept that, your progress will be much more rapid. It'll be easier on you.
But what if there was a record of where the car hit me? And Dr. McKay and I went down there. Maybe it would jog my memory.
If that were the case, I'm almost certain that you would have had some flashes of memory by now. I've had to conclude. All your pre-accident memory is gone. Sad and painful as that is, know that losing your memory was the trade-off to keep you alive.
Andy, why don't you stay and have some dinner?
That'd be great.
Well, listen, Julie, I'm a little confused. Why would you think that Lucinda knew that Holden wasn't on the freighter before Cal and Ned?
I guess it was just because she seemed so calm when she heard the news. I just naturally assumed that she already knew about it, but of course, if Lucinda knew anything, she would have kept it from you.
You know, if Holden pawned his wedding ring, then he just must be desperate to get away from our marriage. I know that he was very angry, but I can't understand how all his feelings for me could just be wiped out.
No, that's not true. Don't even think about that. That's not true.
Julie, can I get you something?
No, I'm fine. I just like being here in the kitchen.
Goodness, I forgot Aaron was here.
No, I'll get him.
No.
You must be hungry.
No, no, please, let me.
I wouldn't be slipping notes under the door if I thought that you were here. Now, you know what this says. Please. Please, Iva. Please.
Lucinda. Lucinda, I'm not going to tell Lily about Holden's visit to Julie or why he was there.
Right. We're witness. We saw what happened to her when she just heard that he
was
not
there. Yes, I know, but it's not me that you have to worry about. It's Julie.
Forget about Julie. Hasn't she any self-interest? No. What would her chances be with Caleb? No. I'm not worried about Julie at all.
Hi. How's Margot?
Well, she's fine. False. What are you doing here?
I'm here to make sure that Iva is on the same wavelength with me when it comes to protecting Lily.
Who's going to protect Lily from you? I happen to know the only reason you told Lily that Holden was on that boat was because Julie threatened to tell her herself.
Oh,
Oh, you love Miss Seattle, right? You love her words.
I have a feeling that Miss Seattle is being honest with us.
John, I didn't tell Lily anything because I don't want to give her false hopes, all right? She's at the breaking point. You ought to see the girl.
Julie also thinks that you knew Holden wasn't on that boat, even before Cal and Ned flew over there to find out.
Julie this, Julie that. I happen to know, dear, that my detective showed a picture of Holden to the woman in the maritime agency, and they identified him definitely as one of the three men on the ship, aren't we? Enough. Now that Iva and I understand each other, I will just get out of your way, and you can get on with your nuptials.
So are we going to the Foxwood Lodge tonight, or what?
These are all good cleaners, but did you know that not one of them disinfects? So you don't get your home totally clean until you use Lysol deodorizing cleaner. Lysol cleans and kills germs without any extra effort. Germs can be anywhere, so don't do part of the job. Lemon Fresh Lysol deodorizing cleaner cleans and disinfects.
Beth and I wanted to knock him dead at our reunion. She got a salon perm, and I gave myself an Ogilvy home perm for a lot less. At the reunion, friends said, "Did you always have such gorgeous curly hair?" They told Beth, "Nice perm. Precisely Rice got automatic shut-off timing. You can't over-perm or under-perm. You just can't get it wrong." People said I looked better than I did in school. So much for the salon.
Oh, cramps, bloating.
Your period can have many symptoms.
I don't feel well.
But ordinary pain relievers, even Tylenol and Advil, relieve only pain. Maximum strength multi-symptom Midol does much more. Midol helps it all go away.
For those with painful mouth sores, we offer pizza without punishment, orange juice without agony, pleasure without pain. Since we offer the most mouth sore pain reliever you can get, maximum strength or a gel mouth aid, now in liquid or gel.
With Hillshire Farm light smoked sausage, you can make meals in minutes. We're giving people a whole new appreciation of fast food. Taste the difference when it comes from Hillshire Farm.
Delicious meal, really.
Good. I can always count on the pampered palate to come to my rescue. My culinary talents are severely limited, I'm afraid.
Like mother, like daughter.
Yeah, right.
I almost missed some of your mother's specialties. Frozen waffles. Just lightly burnt on the outside, sort of icy cold in the middle. Hard to believe it's over.
Then don't believe it. If Daryl and Franny would just get their act together, Mom won't have any reason to be insecure.
Look, even if they don't get their act together, she still has no reason to feel bad about my friendship with Franny.
Hold on now.
Until the veins pop out of my head, she just doesn't buy it. Case in point. The other night, I told her that there was a reason that I'd been especially concerned about Franny. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
I went to Franny and I asked her, could I tell Susan so Susan would understand? Franny said, it's a very personal thing and she'd rather that I didn't.
Let me get this straight. You told Mom you have a secret with Franny that you can't share with her?
Yeah. Well, like I said, it's because Franny asked me not to, and I felt like I had to
Larry,
honor that.
Larry, if a man said he loved me and wanted to share the rest of his life with me, then told me he had a secret with his ex-lover that he couldn't share, I'd do a hell of a lot more than give his ring back. I'd wring his neck.
You're putting me on, right?
Dead wrong. Don't you see? In effect, you're putting Franny's welfare ahead of Mom's. Larry, I like Franny. But I don't think she has the right to ask you to keep a secret from the woman you love and plan to marry.
Did you call Dr. Larry to tell him that we arrived safely?
No, I've been busy with patients.
Why don't you call him now? Inez can talk to him, too.
Well, first of all, I don't know what his plans are tonight, and also, you've got to get to bed. You're sharing a room with Maria, see?
I'm sick. And I'm going to be helping with the light work here so I can pay my way.
Oh, that's good.
You come up to my room to say goodnight?
Oh, yes, absolutely. Yeah.
Good night. Is it my imagination, or are you reluctant about calling Larry?
You might as well know I've broken my engagement to Larry.
Susan, I'm sorry. What happened? Or don't you want to...
No, it's just a lot of little things, you know, that adds up to a lot, suddenly. And I almost finished a glass of wine that he'd left in the bedroom last night, and I hadn't really had to fight temptation that hard in a long, long time. And I really felt that if I stayed in the relationship one of these days, I wouldn't be able to fight it at all.
I didn't realize that you were having those problems.
Well, there's always been the age thing, and now there's some other things.
One of those other things, is it Franny? I know Larry's been spending a lot of time with him lately.
I think Larry's going to have to finally figure out if friendship is really all he wants from Franny. Well, I've got to say goodnight to him, Walt. I'll see you later.
Okay. Hello.
Hello, handsome. I thought I'd probably find you still working.
Well, you're right, as usual. Kim, Susan arrived down here a couple of hours ago.
With Inez, I know. Larry told me.
Look, I don't want you to feel that...
Did Susan say what happened with Larry?
Well, Larry's closeness to Franny is part of it.
Speaking of Franny, I'd like a word with her.
Oh, golly, I'm afraid you're out of luck. When I got back, she'd left a note saying she was going to go out on an errand.
Look, the main reason I asked you here tonight is that I saw something today. It was in a box of stuff that I had to carry down to the vault in Julie's Harper's basement. Small book of love poems. On the inside cover was an inscription from Daryl to Carolyn. Does it mean anything?
Yes, it was in the safe at the house, a part of the things that I took with me to Villars. It must have been stolen when the safe was emptied a few weeks ago, but... Hal, why would Daryl show something so personal to the Harpers? I don't know. Maybe he's been telling the truth after all. Maybe somebody else did rob the safe.
While I was in Anthony's office, he gave me part of a file on Daryl, put in the vault. I took a look at it, and I saw that today, Daryl made final payment to the Harpers for his gambling debt dating back to before he married Carol.
Which would mean he's in line with me about that, too. Daryl always claimed that he borrowed money from Carolyn's father to clear that debt. So all the money he's withdrawn, all the checks made out to cash, he's been using it to pay off his gambling debt.
Not necessarily, Franny.
What do you mean? Exactly.
I mean that I'm convinced that Shorty Martell and Frank Wendell were on the Harper's payroll. And that means that if it was Daryl and not Gavin that hired the Harper's to kill Carolyn, that money could be payment for a burger.
Presenting Mighty Dog. Pound for pound, these guys use up more energy than most dogs twice their size. That's why we make Mighty Dog. It has the perfect balance of nutrients to help them be their best. Mighty Dog. It makes your dog a mighty dog.
You're pure, you're natural, one of a kind. You're my ivory, baby.
You're pure, you're soft, you're just the right touch. You're my ivory, baby.
Unlike soaps with heavy perfumes and greasy creams, ivory is pure. It doesn't need anything else to baby, even a baby skin.
You're my ivory, baby.
Baby your skin with ivory.
Now on video cassette, when a girl named Penny's in trouble,
It's time to call the rescuers in this all-new adventure on video. Now they're calling their friends on land, on sea, and in the air. Walt Disney's The Rescuers on video. Bring it home today.
What's red hot, really powerful, and can perk up anything? Yes, again, it's the Dirt Devil Upright Deluxe. Its revolving brush cleans the dirtiest floor, and you won't have to hunt for attachments. They're built in. So get the Dirt Devil Upright Deluxe and perk up your place.
In a world no bigger than the sandbox, no deeper than the mud between toes, it's spray and wash that has gotten off the food, grease, and grass the little ones get into, more than any other stain remover ever made. And that has given more mothers the quiet strength to send them back out into that little world to do it all over again. More than any other stain remover, spray and wash gets out what America gets into.
I have this feeling. It's hard to explain. It's like you asked me to take a test, and I failed you somehow.
But, Aaron, you've made extraordinary progress. You haven't failed at anything.
Yes, I have. You and Dr. Sussman have been waiting for me to remember something, and I can't.
Aaron, we were hoping that you would have memory flashes, because we weren't sure how much damage had happened. That you haven't isn't your failure. It's out of your control. Look, there are lots of people that would love to get rid of their memories. I would love to get rid of the bad years of my marriage.
Well, it's different because you'd be choosing what you want to forget. Would you give up the bad memories if it meant that you had to give up the good ones, too?
And I know that I hurt him, but I can't believe that everything that Holden felt for me could just be wiped out.
Hey, Julie. What's wrong?
I'd be so afraid to tell you both, but I can't stand to see Lily suffer like this anymore. I have to tell you both. Holden was planning to come back to Lily.
How would you know that, Julie?
He came to see me in New York. He wasn't angry at Lily. He tried to call her. He was heading back to her.
I don't understand, Julie. Why would Holden come to see you in New York?
Because he overheard Lucinda saying that Aaron was his son by me.
You? Huh? I thought you were through our enemy, Julie. You're nothing but a whore. Think that I was a fool. Enough that we had a chance.
Yes, we do. Caleb, I love you. Get away from him.
I knew you'd only hurt him again. But don't worry, Caleb, I'm here. And I'll help you through this. Just as I did when she hurt you before.
What are you doing out here all by yourself?
Just getting some air. I feel so sorry for Lily. I just wish there was something I could do.
Well, we all do, but I think we've done just about everything. Come here.
Good evening.
I'm worried about you, John. Just worried. I don't want you to come out and see how things are going on. John, are you and Ivan never getting married?
Tomorrow.
Darling, come back to town. Will you come home? Come be with me. Mr. Gray has strict orders to telephone me if you have any news. And if you're there, you'll be closer to the source.
Well, you do have a point.
Yeah, I want to be there.
I just want to tell you how grateful I am for all your detectives for doing. You know, even though Holden wasn't on the ship.
Well, since Gray is working with the police, we'll have news soon.
Well, they went to sleep right after Once Upon a Time.
How cautious can I be, Tom? No.
I love you. We will be careful.
We can't be that careful. I can't. Not while I might have this virus inside me.
Whole grain goodness. Roman meal. It's that good.
With the help of Hooked on Phonics, people all across the country have learned to read.
I'm always raving about Hooked on Phonics because it works.
Hooked on Phonics has made the greatest difference in my life.
His report card this semester was the best.
It feels good.
Yeah. I would recommend Hooked on Phonics for any age, though. Any nationality. Anybody.
Call 1-800-ABCDEFG.
It works. That's the bottom line.
It's Sears Days, our biggest Sears Days ever. Right now, this LXI camcorder is a low $599.99 with 8x zoom and high-speed shutter. So don't miss it.
All at Sears Brand Central.
Well, if Joyce is with Chris and Carrie, does that mean Franny's free to come over and have some coffee and dessert?
Your guess is as good as mine. She left a note saying she was on an errand.
Do you suppose she wants to meet Daryl?
No, he called looking for her. Of course, I have no idea when she'll be back.
Have you talked to Bob tonight? Is Mom there yet?
Yes, Susan and Nev both arrived safely.
Oh, look. Charlie changed his desk.
Well, I think they changed the sheet. Listen, Susan, if you can't sleep and you feel like talking, I've got some reading to do, and I'm just on the other side of that wall, and all you got to do is knock a few times.
No, it's okay. I think I'll drop right off.
Well, it's nice to have you here, regardless of the circumstances.
Thank you, Bob. And I promise to keep so busy, I won't have time to feel sorry for myself.
Fair enough. Good night.
So Daryl wants you and Perry to fly to Des Moines. Maybe it's not a bad idea. I know that Evelyn confessed to sleeping with Gavin. I'm wondering if somebody ever tried to blackmail her.
Who would that be, Hal? Evelyn and Gavin are the only two who know about the affair.
Don't count on it, Franny. People like Evelyn, they pay other people to protect their reputations. The next one targets. God knows Gavin was greedy enough to orchestrate it. Maybe he saw it as a way to get off the hook for some of the money he owed to the Harpers.
And you want me to go to Evelyn and find a way to open up the subject?
Yeah. Listen, if you can't handle going to Des Moines with Daryl, I understand, but I think that you should seriously consider it. It could be important if we ever want to get to the bottom of this.
John?
Lucinda and her detectives. I've had enough to hear with her phony concern.
Well, I think her concern for Lily is genuine.
Phony, genuine concern. I'm not buying it anymore. It's the whole family now. Lily the worst. She thinks that Holden left her because she was mad at he was mad at her. And the truth of the matter is that he was on his way back to her. Now, how does she, in good conscience, how do we, in good conscience, keep silent about that? I should go in there right now. We tell Lily the truth. That Holden went to visit Julie in New York. And if need be, we tell her why. Julie can back the whole thing up.
For smiles, and mom's counting tears for savings. Get a 10 by 13, 2 8 by 10, 3 5 by 7, 15 wallets. Half off. Was $21.95, now $10.95. Plus 18 petite free. Get Sears.
Deep down, what's the dirtiest word in your bathroom? Lysol Basin Tub and Tile Cleaner has twice the cleaning power of the original formula to wipe out soap scum. And it even gets rid of germs. Get your bathroom deep down clean with Lysol Basin Tub and Tile Cleaner.
Ghostly odors popping up to haunt your home? Get into the spirit of the islands with Love My Carpet Tropical Blossom. It'll help you get rid of unpleasant odors while the scent of a tropical garden fills the room. Try Love My Carpet Tropical Blossoms and get into the spirit.
You know what my favorite country is? Country scent Lysol spray.
There's not another country like it.
I wouldn't change my country
for $1 million.
Country scent Lysol disinfectant spray is a refreshing blend of country fragrances in a disinfectant spray. Isn't it time you move to a new country?
I love this country.
Why take another cold and flu season lying down? At the first sign of a cold or flu, take Coristina. It relieves your runny nose, congestion, and fever fast, and even helps stop them from getting worse. Coristina D, the sooner the better.
Tonight, the Pirates face the Braves. Tomorrow night, the A's take on the Blue Jays. The battles of October begin with the League Championship Series on CBS.
When drug gangs take over a small town, it takes two cops to turn up the heat.
Possessed of crack cocaine.
He's a witness. And fight to take back the night.
You got anything?
Carol O'Connor.
We gotta get him.
Yeah. Howard Rollins. They're setting us up in the heat of the night. Wednesdays after baseball on CBS.
Almost everyone knows the truth about Holden, everyone except his wife. Will Lily find out tomorrow as the world turns?
Blossoms by Regina Porter.
One Children's Cold Medicine relieves every major symptom.